Summer in Beaumont, Sumer.
The night is warm. The trees are in bloom.
Everything is ripe for the picking. Ready?
The royal ring.
Ah, how could I forget this last vestige of my noble lineage? And through all years of glory and struggle, despite plague and famine, and traitors who took my throne, only this survives in memory of the kingdom that once was. That I bow in the name of my ancestors, shall one day live again. Did you keep the receipt?
Of course.
Let's go get it.
Left hand, side pocket, right arm, akimbo and relaxed. Head up, gaze steady. Now you're ready, so you stroll in. Survey them, your world, they're all invited guests. Feel out how to play them, and remember this, you're giving them what they want.
Zabaduri.
Giving them what they want, an adventure on their own. Giving them what they want, like they're in a movie. But never forget that what they want is half smiles. David,
put on a bold countenance, both tragic and amused.
High style,
come before,
that's a gift.
And don't forget,
all I'm doing is giving them what they want.
Zabaduri.
Exactly what they want.
Tied up with a bow. For as the poet said,
Pete,
truth is beauty.
And that is all you really need to know.
Your Grace.
This lady is Lenore. She feels her life's become a bore. You see, her husband's 94 this May. But hey, she's down to 50 mil in an addendum to his will. And wherever there's a will, there's a way. I always say,
what they want.
Smooth and breezy.
Exactly what they want.
Escape
from the army. Give them what they want.
Now,
sin
sheet or cheesy.
Really wanted.
Exhibit B.
Sophia loaded down with Lyra, spied a gray hair in the mirror. So she made a resolution to cut loose. Her family fortune is obscene. Her dad invented Orangina. Now sit back and watch while I turn up the juice. And then you got to leave them wanting
more, 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 more. Give them what they want, give them what they want, give them what they want. Give them what they want, some sugar and tea. Give them what they want.
Here, I'll make it easy. Remember what they really wanted.
What we really want is
me.
Maybe.
So an American.
Of course.
Numero dues, noir.
Well, mayor.
Is your entree? Would you please ask the manager what he might allow me for this?
Your highness, not the royal ring.
Shh. You want the whole world to know?
Excuse me, is that man actually royalty?
No, madame.
But you called him your highness.
A faux pas. Please, I've already caused the prince enough trouble.
The prince?
The prince.
A prince?
Forget I said anything.
Well, he seemed upset.
Well, between the war and famine and pestilence, he has a lot on his plate.
A famine? My god, well please let me help.
No, no, no.
I have an excellent caterer.
If you truly wish to help, forget everything I told you tonight. Forget everything you've heard about that glorious, extraordinary man of destiny.
Oh, of course. Excuse me, your highness. I couldn't help but overhearing. Perhaps I can help. Can I help well? I'm sure I can help.
Please, I have powerful enemies. They should be watching this.
What is it?
Nothing. I just usually find that jewelry tends to enhance a woman's beauty, but in your case, the opposite is true. It attracts from what is already perfection.
Really? Well.
Amazing.
You know I have a tiara in my room.
That could do it.
I was reading some papers this morning. From the front page of today's Le Monde, it seems a clever young American con artist nicknamed the Jackal has been rumored to be working along the southern coast of France.
Andre, just make the front page. How clever can he be?
Still, it might be wise to keep an eye out.
I'm sure we'll know when we see him.
Bon voyage!
Au revoir, mon ami.
Ah, Mr. Jameson, I hope you have a lovely stay in Switzerland.
I'm banking on it.
Mr. Jameson, I hope you had a lovely stay in Switzerland.
I feel like I never left.
Belmont-sur-Mer, Madame and Monsieur, Belmont-sur-Mer, en voiture, Madame and Monsieur.
Excuse me.
Oh, 1 second, please. That Judas, what a character, huh? Oh, thanks, I'm sorry. Whoa! Is this to rent or to buy? I'll just have a napkin, please.
One napkin. The food here is very good.
Oh, I'm sure it is, but I had such a big breakfast and oh!
Are you all right?
Hunger pains, they'll pass.
You must eat something.
You know, to be honest with you, I never was very good with money. I seem to take whatever salary the Red Cross pays me and donate it right back to them. At this rate, Grandma will never get her operation.
Your grandmother, she's in?
Oh, she just picked over sometimes. I cannot wait to see her face Christmas morning when she wakes up and finds that new hip under the tree.
You must let me in.
Oh, no, I can't.
Nonsense. Wait till I get this man a special dessert.
Thank you. Gosh, I never knew angels had such beautiful breasts. For that?
Wait, is he Jedi? And you are?
Bishop Peter O'Malley.
One moment, please.
See you in church.
My condolences to your grandmother. You said she tends to tip over?
Only when she's loaded.
Oh, I see. It's rather a dirty trick, isn't it?
I'm just giving the people what they want.
Which is?
Beautiful woman like that, how often does she get to feel all good and charitable about herself? And what did it cost her? Look at this. She gave me $20.
Wow.
You know what it feels like to take a woman for $20?
Now, I'm afraid that's a little out of my class.
Ah, don't sell yourself short. You know what? I can show you the ropes. I hear some dames really go for your type.
Oh, really?
Sure, they like them older.
No, I've never had much luck with women.
Who they are. I'm sizing you up for a Scientologist.
No.
Lawyer?
No.
Maitre d'.
No.
Mormon? Shepherd?
No. Actually, I'm a dentist.
I was just gonna say dentist.
Amazing.
Well, some of us got it and some of us ain't.
I'll say.
I never realized how long my heart had been ignored. He sang my name and it rang out just like some major chord. If music be the root of love being my smorgasbord, what was a woman? What was a woman? What was a woman to
do? Well, no danger of wisdom.
Thanks, Doc. That's a relief.
Indeed.
How much do I owe you? Thanks, Doc.
20 stuffers.
What?
Last night I met a princess. Last night I met a prince. I have a perfect head of cards.
Belmont-sur-Mer on a revet.
Well, you coming?
Gee, I don't know.
You need a place to stay, you're more than welcome. I have a sister I'd love for you to meet. Everyone says she's the prettiest girl in town.
Oh yeah? What's she look like?
A bit like me, actually, except for the mustache.
You don't have a mustache.
No, I don't.
You know, I think I'll check this Isla place out.
Well, Bertha will be disappointed, but I suppose it's for the best.
Yeah. Hey, listen. Thanks for the tip.
My pleasure. Bon voyage! Oh, get off!
Oh, thank you. I am smart.
Psst. Psst. I see you're a comrade of the prince. The man you were just kissing.
Wait, he was kissing me. I didn't even enjoy it.
Oh, viva la resistance.
Thanks, you too.
I can't tell you how proud I am and how glad I felt doing nothing.
Listen, lady. I think you may be a little off here. That guy's name was Lawrence Jameson.
I'm not to care. It's all right. He swore me to secrecy, too. We met at the casino in Beaumont-sur-Mer.
Beaumont-sur-Mer?
In fact, it's my money that's funding his mission.
Is that so?
Perhaps he mentioned me. Did he mention me? Well, I'm sure he mentioned me. Muriel Eubanks, Omaha, Nebraska. Lady Muriel by moonlight. He made me a dame.
I'll just bet he did.
I can't tell you how proud I am to have the Eubanks fortune supporting such a worthy cause. Oh, please, for His Highness to wear it to battle, you'll be sure to give it to him, won't you?
Oh, I'll be giving it to him, all right.
Overhead, chateau, staff pension, and your commission?
Merci.
And this for the little sisters of both. Beaumont-sur-Mer.
So much?
Well, let's not be greedy, my friend, except for our running with that feed-eating jackal on the train. We've had a pretty smooth season so far.
Ah, please, next to you, that so-called jackal was but a poor little pussycat.
Well, I mean, you could say one thing for him, though. He still enjoyed the game. I remember when we were first starting out. How long have we been running this act, anyway?
Let's see. At the time you were 40. Now you're 36. So, 14 years.
Don't you ever miss that sense of danger and excitement?
No.
Fun of making it up as we went along?
No.
Still, there's something to be said for a bit of chaos now and then. The thrill of the roller coaster, lure of the swirling eddy.
Be careful what you wish for. Fun is nothing to be taken lightly.
God, you'd be such a spoiled sport.
Well, I am the chief of police.
Don't we have some business to attend to?
We do.
Who's on our dance card for today?
The luridly wealthy Miss Jolene Oakes of Oakes, Oklahoma.
Age?
31.
Married?
Constantly.
Money?
Her people are loyal.
Group?
Well, she's a little pushy.
Must be the heiress at the gate now.
Ready?
Well, one moment. Reading's important, but lighting is everything. No red.
Get those drain them out! The prince's enemies have followed me. Oh, your majesty. I bring you this message from abroad. Real interesting broad, too. Run that up your flagpole, you lying, cheat, and dirty, rotten man! Are you good?
Hello, pretty.
Wow!
All right, how much do you want?
I'll put your dough away, don't wait. Wow! Wow! Wow!
Then what do you want?
What do I want? Teach me! Mold me! Make me your clay! I thought I'd seen it all. I thought I knew the score. But coming here, I found the world I've never seen before. Now I know where I belong. I want taste and class with culture and sophistication pouring down my ass. Ow! Like what? I want this. I want this. Ah, I want this. I thought I had a real gift, a penny ante grift. But Freddy's getting ready now to give his life a lift. I'm tired of being a chump. I wanna be like Trump. 200 pounds of caviar in one gigantic lump. Give me great big stuff, this is how I gotta live. Great big stuff, oh no alternative. Great big stuff, I want my silver spoon. Don't need it right now, but I better get it soon. Yeah! Oh. Babies in my glass bottom boat. A house in the Bahamas. Paisley silk pajamas. Poker with Al Roker and Andre Lorenzo Llamas. Give me great big stuff. I really do deserve it. Big serve it. Who will serve it? Big stuff. I don't give a damn what it's worth. Every day's my birthday. Every night is my barman's birthday. Give me a home where the centerfolds roam. Guccione on the pony, got a party going on. And Pep will have me over and play some naked twister. Lotto in the grotto with the flaming and her sister. Rap stars will love me. Get me a hussy night. Chilling in the city, sitting pretty. With me, Daddy, or Puff Diddy, or whatever. I'll change my name too. Get my ass back all pimped out.
Why?
I'm in Hamptons in the winter, the Hamptons in the summer. The fashion play I did will make me hum it in my hummer. The cash to keep me idle, the chicks to keep me vital, the pills to keep me happy even when I'm suicidal. Oh no, big girls so crappy. That would make me very happy.
I realized that day that I would have to use these attributes to create a world that I couldn't access otherwise. Ready? What I'm trying to say is, no new limitations.
Which are?
You're a moron.
Hey, is that any way to talk to your favorite student?
Ridiculous proposition at best.
Oh, well, don't get all highnessy with me. All I'm asking is you polish me up a little. Come on, it'll be fun.
Like an auto de-fe.
I drive a Fiesta.
You do realize I could have you arrested.
For what?
Whatever I choose.
Yeah, well, you can throw me in the moat too, but I don't think you're gonna do either.
Why not?
Because I got a big mouth, and a guy like you has already figured out that a guy like me can ruin an awful lot of business around here for a guy like you. Got something to eat. You know, this could work out swell all around. Good for me, good for you, good for... Nugget? Oh. So, are we on? Oh.
You can't be serious.
Why not?
You can't afford the distraction.
Distracts me just what I need.
If it's a roller coaster you want, I'll take it as a fare. I'll even buy you a pencil. What?
Pencil?
See something? Pencils, I don't know.
No, this is better.
Think of the risk.
Think of the challenge. He's so deliciously low, so horribly dirty.
Exactly.
Guys, I'm still in the room.
Shut!
Very well, Freddy. I will show you what I know.
Yes!
No!
But you must look past the shallow two-dimensional creature that's there to something finer.
Impossible.
Greater.
Ridiculous.
Deeper.
Disaster.
You know, I'm starting to think this guy doesn't like me.
Let's begin.
I'm telling you, it's madness.
In what?
We'll dress up a monkey in our money. He may seem precocious and
ow.
Despite all that forbidden, you've still got to chip in a suit.
Very funny.
Teach him the second verse of Swanee. And most of them liver to boots. Sure, people
won't grow,
but you've still got an eight in a suit.
You know that?
Spritzing and wet, it's an old toilet. And you're still gonna get a stench. Dump on him well in a quart of Chanel. It won't cover the smell. I should know, I'm French. Take him to see Don Giovanni. Show him his own lovely fruits.
Yeah.
No, thank you, Jolene.
Well, you can't just sit there on your piece throughout that. Let's dance!
Jolene, my piece is not the question here.
Well, it's gonna be.
Mother.
Oh, Rubric. Rubric, you're not gonna go mad. Rubric! Do you want me to get the cuff? And now he's upset you.
Not at all.
Now, that's right, it's the same old story every generation or so. The mud will be flowing along as blue as the Danube when suddenly a piece of magnetic driftwood.
Your brother is.
You see, my dear, every royal family, by its nature, has a sort of price that it must pay. Every noble lineage has one loose gene, small as a molecule, fitting round the family pool. Sort of thing one sees in Appalachia, or in the odd, inbred Dijon frise. Really, it can be such a nasty stain on discussion. Wisp of DNA begins to fray and goes astray. The Caligulas had the Habsburgs had the chin. George III went cuckoo bird, and Nero had that violin. Richard, you remember, had the hump in the withered limb. The Bushes of Tex were nervous wrecks because their son was dim, but look what happened to him. Alas, our family also carries a bit of a curse, but not a great deal worse. Thus ends the verse. Rick's all about sun and soda pop paws on puppy dogs, candy canes. Rubric's crazy about chocolate bunnies and breezy afternoons and daisy chains. With a little brother like this, you can't help but have a happy home. With style upon grace and a smile upon his face, and all that's missing is a chromosome. All about hugs and valentines, that's why people all say, hey Rubric, you're really okay. Rubric's all about cake and lemonade,
milkshake animals,
fun and play. Rubric's all about
Burmese belly rubs, brown hot casserole and
mile and a half, and a laugh and a hearty how'd you do?
How'd you do?
It's a cinch that we will be a happy family. One plus one plus one
makes two. Rubric's crazy about taxidermy, and when you gotta touch him, use a rubber glove.
Don't give him a chance, all three. Let him get to know ya. Who's the happy chappy with the ulcerated ear?
Rubric!
Who stays awake all night, pondering out with fear?
Rubric!
Who likes to spend every Saturday at the abattoir? It's the cat rod if he tries to hump the samovar. Who likes to save up all his farts in a mason jar? You guessed it!
Ave Maria.
Madame.
Hello.
What are you doing?
I've spent the last 5 days trying to find the prince's country on the map. Is it to the left or the right of the Alps?
Yes.
Oh. Anyway, I thought as long as I'm here, I should pitch in. I'm a docent at our museum back home, and I minor in art history, so I know a lot about these places. Or I just make it up. May I call your attention to the rapture of Louis Leboeuf, following a brief career as a Gregorian chanteuse, a poor peasant girl married the CEO of a major pharmaceutical company, and after 18 years of devotion, caught up with a dental hygienist half his age. Praying for guidance, she took him to the cleaners, had some work done, and voila!
That's not her story.
No, it's mine. But that story works in every century. Did His Highness receive my scarf?
Ah, yes. It was a battlefield.
I've been searching the papers, but there's not so much as a mention.
Well, it's just a little revolution. We don't like to make a big fuss.
Oh, but you must. If you'd like, I can talk to some of the other women around town, rally the troops. You know, I'm in charge of snacks at our neighborhood watch, and telemarketing coach for our local PBS fund drive.
You have a lot of energy, don't you?
Well, I have a lot of time.
Yes. Well, let me talk it over with the other rebels, and we'll get back to you. In the meantime, it was lovely running into you, and goodbye.
Goodbye. Maybe I should stay. Should I stay? Yes, I should stay.
Why?
Should he need me if there's anything more I can do?
Madame, please. Your generosity is already a legend.
Oh.
And between you and I, there was talk of a snatch.
Of me?
Well, try to act surprised.
Oh, I am. I only got a tote bag from PBS.
Ah, yes, well, there goes your group, but don't lose them. Goodbye.
Goodbye. Hey, can I be a stamp instead?
A stamp?
Yeah, I think I'd rather be a stamp.
Then a stamp you will be.
Really?
An entire nation of people will lick your head. Oh, look, they're getting so small, like little tiny people in the distance going away. Go, be one of them.
Oh, goodbye.
Goodbye. We'll miss you.
Will you?
Only if you leave.
I can't tell you how much this means to me.
And yet, you're going to, aren't you?
When I was just a little girl, so young and innocent, I'd kneel beside my little bed and say a prayer I still remember. This is how it went. Let me have love unending. Let me look good in shorts. And now I'm not a child and years have passed, I'd say my miracle is due. Yet I'm still searching, vainly lurching as the world spins round. What is a woman? What is a woman to do? Oh, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Here, keep the card, call me a cab. I'll wait outside. I was never in Europe, you never saw me. Comprendo, y'all are peculiar.
And so, as the pigeons say farewell to Beaumont-sur-Mer, a new flock comes home to roost.
This is Christine Colgate of Cincinnati, Ohio.
Age?
29.
Married?
Never.
Money?
They call her the American Self-Queen.
Please extend all your possible courtesies to her highness.
Of course.
I will say we made quite a good team there.
Yeah, we did!
Of course, I usually prefer working alone, but special circumstances and all.
Hey, I don't even like double solitaire!
So I suppose we'll be moving on now.
Oh, yeah, I guess so.
What was that?
Sorry, what did you say?
Nothing.
Neither did I.
Of course, we stay on a bit, see what more you have to learn.
I guess I can do that.
Good.
You know, just in case you get into another jam.
I don't get into jams.
Yeah, right.
Excuse me?
Oh, come on. If it weren't for me, you'd be on the prairie, plucking your own dinner right now.
I'll admit you're an effective prop.
Prop? Hey, Rupert was the star of that show. You were just the MC.
I prefer to see myself as the ventriloquist.
Which makes me what, a dummy? Oh
my God, that was easy.
Ha ha!
So ready.
No, forget it. I'm out of here.
Prime.
I was going to swallow my own. I've been in my own since I was 15. Yeah, thanks. Thanks to Yahoo. Yeah, don't worry about me. I'll do just fine.
Just you and your beats and your imaginary grandmother.
Hey, for your information, that old broad was the most respected bookie in St. Louis.
St. Louis.
She'd tell me a hell of a lot more about life than you. Talk like this, walk like that, zip your fly, don't snore at the opera.
Awesome.
It was 6 hours. I mean, geez, I don't even want to have sex and eat bacon for 6 hours.
Freddie, he's you've got under your skin.
Yeah, well, you know.
That's why you'll never make it in this game.
Listen!
No, you listen.
Not me, bro.
This is an arm's length business, my friend.
This is hot, bro.
And as the man said, we are the stuff that dreams are made of. Their dreams. Not ours. What they want. Not you. If you can have the patience, which I highly doubt, you'll get your castle in time. But you better build your walls high, because as soon as you let someone else in, the game is over.
Yeah, well, you're a...
who?
You know what? I think you're scared.
Of what?
Me. Face it, Pops. I'm younger than you. I'm charminger than you.
Charminger.
And I'm better looking than you.
Now you've gone too far.
If I was running this place, you'd be finished.
My boy, you wouldn't last 2 minutes.
Wanna bet?
Are you challenging me?
Why not?
What do you think? Oh. All right, Freddy, suppose we do this. We select a woman, we set a price, and whoever extracts the proper amount wins.
How much?
I don't know. I'll make it easy for you. Say $50,000.
$50,000? Sure, I could use a little pocket change.
If I win, you not only leave town graciously, but you agree to work in only the following territories. China, Iceland, El Salvador, and to show that there are no hard feelings, I'll throw in Lancaster.
And if I win?
Then I abdicate.
Great.
Step it down. Step it down.
Great. So who's the dame?
She's here!
Excuse me. excuse me, I am so sorry. I am so sorry. Excuse me, miss, would you mind placing a bet for me? It's sort of hard for me to reach.
Okay, what number?
Gee, the way my luck's been running lately, why don't you pick?
Okay, well, let's see. I'm the second oldest. I was born in July, and I was a Kappa at Ohio State, so how about four? Yeah!
Mesdames et messieurs, les jouets sont faits. Numéro 17.
Thank you, but I'd really rather be alone right now.
Of course, I'm sorry.
It's just that ship was my last hope. Thought maybe if I can spin it into enough and pay for the treatment. So naive. I'm sorry, I can't believe I'm telling my troubles to a total stranger like this.
I'm Christine Colgate.
Sergeant Fred Benson.
Now we're not strangers anymore.
Hey, I guess you're right. I don't mind with myself so much. Just like Grandma was sort of counting on me to come back and run the farm.
Shouldn't the Army pay for your treatment?
It's a little more complicated than that. You see, my problem isn't physical, it's emotional.
You mean?
Yes. I'm afraid what I have is dance fever.
Oh my God! What happened?
I was engaged to the most wonderful girl back in the States. We loved to dance. We wanted to be professionals. Then one day, some talent scouts came to town for a contest for Dance USA.
I love that show!
Me too!
Oh my God!
Then, it was the big night. We won. In all the excitement, we got separated. I looked everywhere. Then I went back to the studio, and there they were, dancing. Naked.
Oh my God, who was she with?
The Dance USA Orchestra.
All of them?
Just the brass section. That night, I tried to sleep, but I just kept dreaming of them dancing, making love. When I woke up, I was completely numb from the waist down. I've been this way ever since.
There has to be someone that can help you.
Well, there is one psychiatrist, Dr. Emil Schuffhausen of the Schuffhausen Clinic of Vienna.
Well, why don't you go to him?
Well, a man like Dr. Schuffhausen is in demand all over the world. His fees are astronomical. It's just not something I can handle.
How astronomical?
Oh, $50,000.
That is a lot of money.
Master with a stiletto, and an absolute magician at hiding the body.
Knocker.
I give you my word of honor as a policeman that the case will be investigated in a very slipshod.
Now, I just need time to think.
Suit yourself. Are you sure?
Is wonderful too.
Nothing is too wonderful to be true.
Go on.
Ah, crap. Sometimes God grants your heart's desires. Once I was caller number 8, I won a set of tires. They held up that midget with crazy glue. Nothing is too wonderful to be true. Nothing is too wonderful to be true.
Martine's a poisoner. A quick souffle, a peaceful sleep. Delicious, but effective.
No, Andre. We all know my intimate relationship with Lady Luck. All I need is a simple one little.
And when it seems your hopes and dreams are on the run again, bad luck has won again, and it won't stop. The clouds will part, and you'll start to see the sun again. And life's a ball, you're standing tall.
Feels this. there? Is this little piggy sick?
Nothing.
Would this little piggy the same? Then I suppose it's futile to wiggle or doodle or jiggle. This bigger. There ain't that a shame. Und this bar.
Like wood.
Und this bar. Sehr gut. That's the entire contingent. We'll have to try something a little more stringent.
Stringent?
Trust me, Fräulein. Maybe doctor. Then I was young, I was cute, and I was in the institute. They banged it in us like a drum. The corpus hippocratic gum. Just before you graduate, you raise your hand, won't stand up straight, won't everybody have to quote that zippy hippy crappy quote. You swear to God to heal the sick, but do no damage, that's the trick. Even if you have to knock a leg, or God forbid, an arm, suppose the best, or crack a chest, or slice him open like a burst. But first, do no harm. You let me move. Nothing.
No.
Medical professional, before he starts a session done, be sure to pause, won't clear his head, won't think on what's told. Out of heart, bestowed on us, this noble art, won't let me tell you it ain't easy, in 380 feet. Defense of equal, won't mend the ill, prescribe a bill, then send the bill. Many years, the system has been working like a charm. Must recollect, great respect, hypocrisy's a bunty first, but first. Lovely, my boy.
Doctor, it just seems so cruel.
On the contrary, Fräulein, Sergeant Benson would be the heaviest man on earth to feel anything. Yeah.
You bet.
Let's all yodel. Like bats, out of the attic gum. Like books, out of the daddy gum.
Like nylon chains, the way static gum.
Like jockeys from the paddock gum.
Or fish thing from the haddock gum.
Or you, psychosomatic gum. Me.
Oh, please, you must all join join me for a drink?
That would be wonderful. Is your Andre a moment?
Certainly. Tigsis.
Andre, I'm afraid we teeter here.
So it seems.
All right, I'll put Miss Colgate away, but you distract the other.
How?
How else? She's a woman, you're French.
Only by birth and affectation.
You'll be fine.
No, please!
It's a revolution afoot.
All right.
Perhaps I should pray for the freedom fighters. Should I pray? Let us pray.
Excellent idea.
Oh, good idea. Okay.
Not you, my dear.
Who's that?
One of my former patients. You can't win them all.
So keep us in mind. Where did he go?
Who?
The prince.
Ah, the prince. He was called away. There was a problem with the court jester.
Oh, well, I must go to him.
But madame.
I've done community theater. Perhaps I could be of some help.
You can. To me. I must warn you, my dear. I am a master at the princely art of seduction.
Oh, okay.
Yep. Gum?
Oh, no, thank you.
I'm sorry, madame. I am no France. I rule no kingdom. I merely live on the outskirts. Pardon me.
Well, you can't give up that easily. All you've got to do is set the mood.
You think it would help?
Well, it couldn't hurt.
Tex, have you got anything?
A little moonlight might be nice.
A moon?
Every good seduction needs a moon.
But you're a moon.
Now, give it a shot.
Round as a balloon, suspended like a bubble in the sky. Like that, the tune that wafts above the dune and sweetly flutters like a butterfly. There's a password parfait we have met another day, when we both were young and gay and thin.
Hey.
But the present's rather tense, so I think it makes some sense for us to both give up. Like that, this kind of vision start to fight. Passage you and I cannot dismiss. So I'm wishing for a dose of being nice and close. Like this, like that, like this.
Of the future we can tell. So we hope it turns out well. No one can know just when his bell will toll. So let's leave it to you now. And let it show us how to find a way to lose control. Like that, it goes. And like the truth, it knows. But nowhere near as perfect as a kiss.
And so I am no prince.
No prince.
My looks may make you wince.
No wince.
I offer you romance.
Romance.
Come on, let's dance.
Oh, yes.
Thank God.
Smack him one.
You know, I wouldn't mind so much, but you...
peace, the more we kiss.
Oh, she's got the money.
Only by selling off everything she owns.
Come on, she's keeping the fabric softener.
Freddy.
Fine, forget about her money. But the bet's still on. We'll think up a whole new bet.
Oh, come on, what bet?
I don't know, a completely new bet.
Freddy, she doesn't have anything.
Then she's the bet.
What do you mean?
What do you think I mean?
No.
Look, if we
Freddy, I said no.
Oh my gosh. You're falling for, aren't you?
Don't be ridiculous.
Timber!
Don't be falling for anybody. It's simply a question of professional ethics.
You know, you've been running this game so long, I think you finally conned yourself.
And the one thing for sure, a woman like her would never fall for a man like you.
You actually believe that?
I know that.
You wanna bet? Ready to bet.
But I'm not competing, I'm merely betting that you fail.
Loser leaves town?
Loser leaves town.
You're on.
Exactly.
There.
Where?
Here.
Oh. Frank!
Hi, Lord!
Frank!
May I roll in?
Well, of course. Sorry. I thought Dr. Schuffhausen sent you home.
He did, but I started thinking of sleeping.
Well, what were you thinking about?
I realized tonight I've lost faith.
But you can't!
I know that now. The problem isn't in my legs at all, or in my mind. It's in my heart. Like Dr. Schuffhausen said, how I could walk again if the desire was strong enough. If I just had someone to walk to.
Well, what do you mean?
I'm in love with you, Christine.
What?
And I think I could walk again if I believed you loved me too.
What?
I'm sorry, I should have said that. I'll just go!
Don't go!
Please don't toy with me, Christine!
I'm not!
Home. I was alone and cold before. I tried to fly, but my wings were cramped till you came along.
Implement the plan to guide me to my exit rail. Do, do, do. Love is my leg, and you are my love. So you are my leg, my love. Finally, I understand how open the hand that squeezes a heart and helps it to start once again.
And walk me!
I can't!
You can! Take on a toes, attached to your feet, so I'll be your seat completely. Always there, driving your socks, allowing your socks, no longer there.
Trust me, I'll take care of everything for you.
Can't I at least call Buzz to say goodbye?
No, Giuseppe B's reverse idea. His mind is in sort of very precarious state. It could snap at a collision, change a cookie.
But I think I may really have feelings for him. If he has feelings for me too.
Then it is even more important that you go away for a while. Okay. Trust me. It's one last time.
What about your feet?
Do what I tell you, and you don't forget about the feet.
Really?
You are even more than generous.
Well, I just did what anyone would do. Besides, knowing I helped a man like Buzz with his life again, that's worth more to me than all that money or that jewelry. There really is no better prize than that.
I never knew people like you. You are genuine, sincere.
Thank you. What about you? You gave up your vacation, you spend your whole life helping people?
Believe me, I'm no saint.
Is it okay if I believe you are?
That would be nice.
Madam, your ticket.
You're not going with the lady?
No, she's just a friend.
Are you certain? She seems a bit moonstruck.
Love sneaks in when everything seems quiet. Sets the bait, and like a fool, you buy it. Your famous self-possessions vanished from your repertoire. This is what can happen when you leave the door ajar. And love sneaks in and whispers you sweetly silly words that change your life completely. You're fumbling in the dark. The master's now the mark. You're out of luck if love sneaks in on you. What's this?
You're a wonderful man, Dr. Chappell.
No,
I can't.
Has been nicely played. The mockers, now the mocked. That's what tends to happen when you leave yourself unlocked. And love sneaks through the usual defenses, sighs and smiles and stale old pretenses. What's gone is what you were. What's left is all of stung, you're stuck. Well, love snuck in with her.
Ow! I think that's your knee.
Oh, yeah.
That you may be right.
I'm sorry, I don't speak French.
Well, I should.
Oh, me too. I'd like to thank you for a lovely time. I'll never forget the generous hospitality of you showing me the sights of your little town, or the heat of you kissing me cross-eyed like some glorious French stallion.
Excuse me?
It really is a charming place.
Ah, yes. Well, perhaps next time I can show you the countryside. There's the most delightful little vineyard, where you can once again get me in a lip lock of love until the wine of your lust flows from my eyes.
Oh. What?
So I make cheese, too.
Well, I doubt I'll be back this way again.
You are quite the woman of the world.
Not really. You know how it is. You open up a map, point, and think, maybe there. So you pack your bags full of dreams and go. Only, those bags can get awfully heavy after a while.
Perhaps it's time to leave them behind.
My bags?
Yes.
They're Louis Vuitton.
Someone to help carry them then?
Oh, that might be nice.
Perhaps I could.
Yes.
That is, we might always.
Yes.
I'll call the porter.
Oh, good idea. You know, it really is charming here. even without a miracle. Of the future, who can tell? So we hope it turns out well. No one can know just when his bell will toll.
Hey, Romeo! Shh.
Now, and let it show us how to find a way to lose control.
Hey, look what those two sailors did to me.
I'm like Dale Evans on her wedding night.
Please, the lady is singing.
Where's Christine?
Gone. The game is over.
You mean over?
I mean, you've lost. Bon voyage, friend.
But, shh. Gone? She can't be gone. Gotta stop her.
These are on official police business, of course.
Of course. You know what this means, don't you?
I do. You really should have let me buy you that big pencil.
No. Bet's a bet. Loser leaves town. About time I packed up and moved on from this place anyway. I must be the jackal at the gate now. Here to gloat over his victory, no doubt.
May I at least trip him as he enters? Thank you. Sorry.
Dr. Schaffhausen?
My dear, what's the matter?
I know what you said, but I had to see him again. I thought I was in love with him. We went back to my hotel room.
I see.
I mean, it was really quite romantic aside from the concussion. Really sad about it was, but when I woke up, he was gone, and he took everything, all of my money. What kind of a man would do something like that?
What kind would be? Ms. Audrey?
Consider it done.
I'm starting to think that he could walk all along, that he just used me to get to my money. I mean, it was everything. My traveler's checks, even my little change purse. $50,000.
But I told you I paid my fee.
It had already gotten here. I had it in my bag. What am I going to tell my father? Some of that money was his.
Mr. Andre, I have my car brought around.
What are you doing?
Simply covering your losses.
But you're not responsible. How could you have known?
Any good-looking psychiatrist could have seen that he was a charlatan. Anyways, it's cheaper than a malpractice suit, which I have no doubt you've been.
I don't feel good about taking your money.
I feel good. Now go.
Sometimes I wish I...
Yeah?
If you're ever in Cincinnati, would you give me a call?
Of course.
I can't take this. It doesn't belong to me. Besides, I'll always have something from you worth so much more.
The jackal has been captured.
Ha!
We found him at the hotel at the scene of the crime.
What crime? What are you guys talking about?
I knew you were low, but I never knew you.
Me? What are you trying to pull now?
You worm.
More louse?
You? You give swindling a bad name.
Well, this thing is ventilated.
Listen, Freddy. This time she really is gone. You'll never see her again.
What? You let her get away?
Christine! Christine!
Oh, you! Rupert! You let her get away!
How would you do that to her?
You what to her? Look in the room. The lights are low. I've got it made. All systems go. Down the hair, the gown. We go to kiss. She conks me out. I wake up with nothing on. My clothes, my shoes are gone. My wallet is gone, my watch is gone. And here I am, a schmuck in a robe.
And you expect me to believe that when she just returned the $50,000 I gave her?
What $50,000?
The $50,000 that you stole from her!
I didn't steal any $50,000 from her! Hey, here's my clothes.
You were right. They are a little heavy.
Well,
have a safe journey home.
I'll probably just take a Benadryl and sleep straight over Lisbon.
Ah, yes. I, too, have been grateful for some privacy. Mild antihistamine.
Well.
Well. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Perhaps I can help you to the gate?
Oh, thank you. I'll just call the porter.
Right. Well, goodbye.
Goodbye.
Perhaps a gum for the flight. The pressure on the ears can be quite distressing.
You know, I think I have some in my bag.
Magazine? Peanuts? Toblerone?
Thank you, I'll be fine.
I could blow up your little neck pillow.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. I'll miss you.
Will you?
Only if you leave.
Ask me.
Okay.
Yes!
Yes?
I like it here.
But there's no prince.
I know.
No kingdom.
I know.
No fantasy.
Well...
Well, there was the one last night.
The Prussian butler?
The French maid? Are you certain?
No, are you?
Not at all.
Well, that'll do it!
When do you think she was on to us?
From the beginning, Freddie. From the very beginning.
I still can't believe we fell for it.
Well, we must be too hard on ourselves. She had accomplices.
Who?
Us. Just giving the people what they want.
So, what will you do now?
Well, season's over. Autumn's coming. Closing up part of the house. I think it's time I go back home for a while.
London?
Detroit.
Well, there's always next season.
Maybe.
But maybe not? Really? Nah.
Ready?
You may be master of your chosen occupation, with several strings of polo ponies in your stable. You must remember all the same that at the crux of every game is knowing when it's time to leave the table. And it's important to be artful in your exit. No turning back, you must accept the time is done. But now and then you might recall the moment when you had it all. You had the charm, you had the talent, and my God, you had the fun. It was a fall, it was a blast. It's a shame, it could last, cause every chapter asked you when you must agree. It was a joy, it was a fun, a splendid way to earn a dime for a dirty, rotten guy like me. When you look back on all your conquests and deceptions, see a thousand tallest pearls and shreds. Lay out the spirits of Rome, one is perfect as a poem, and hope is to be proud of, though it's written in the sand. It was a ball, it was a thrill, you had the grace, you had the skill, to know exactly what to say and what to do. You wouldn't trade a single day, or have it any other way, a dirty, rotten guy like you.
Almost religion, the need to take a pigeon, play your part with elegance and zest. But when it's time to pull the act, and your duffel bag is packed, take comfort in the bags that you've been working with the best. It was a blast, it was a ball, it was a gas, I loved it all, cause I was hanging with the man and that's a plus.
You got the fur,
you got the guts,
you got the nerve.
You got the nuts.
I guess we're dirty, rotten,
dirty, rotten,
dirty, rotten guys.
It was a trip, it was a blast, it was a shame, they couldn't last. It was almost too prodigious to discuss.
So we got screwed for 50 grand.
I think we still deserve a hand.
Like us.
me, Freddie. It was my pleasure. What you lack in grace, you more than make up for in vulgarity.
Thank you. You know, you're a smooth guy. You'll always be the best.
Hope you can still say that when I'm old and gray.
I just did.
Well,
I guess I should. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Hold it! Hold on! Excuse me! Ahoy! You out there? Bring up the bags pronto! Long time no see, boys! First intro, okay? Nico! Nico! Come on!
Nico.
Get up here! I want you to meet Mr. Big Stuff!
both my wings went grim till you came along. And with the lens that guide me to my exit.